backup dancers?
Yes.
That's all open auditions. Can I get like bumped up in that? That's all I needed to hear. Place where the people wonder why. While the grass is always greener on the other side. I feel like people who hear your music often think you've been playing guitar your whole life because you're just so incredibly talented, but with guitar that's not necessarily the case.
No, I started 6 years ago.
Yeah, so how did that all begin?
It's my last semester in college, and I had been kind of drifting away from the piano for a while, actually. Maybe when I was about 19, mm-hmm. My second year in college, and I didn't want to play classical piano anymore.
Because that's what you'd been playing since you were young.
And yeah. Only that. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, every now and then I'd go and play some gigs with my dad, like on the keys, but I did start my own band in high school my last year, but it fell apart very quickly.
Go girl, what was the name of that band?
Jackie and the Gents.
And the Gents. Do you remember like the first chord that you learned?
Yeah, E.
There you go. The E, you'll never forget that.
Yeah.
So what advice would you give your younger self? Like, you know, you grew up in Austin, you've seen the city change so much, you've seen yourself change probably. Is there advice you would give yourself as a younger kid?
Be very militant about the energy you allow in your life. I don't waste any time on people who don't bring good energy to the table.
You know, you're a musician, that comes with many elements. There's writing, there's recording, there's performing. What's at the top of the list for you?
I like to practice and write so that I can perform, and I won't have anyone to perform for if I don't promote myself. So, but the music always comes first.
Yeah. What venues kind of stand out as significant on your journey?
In Austin?
Mm-hmm. Because one-to-one
bar, mm-hmm. Sahara Lounge, and Antone's are kind of like the top three for me right now. Sahara Lounge gave me my first gig.
You will never forget who gave you your first gig.
Yes, and one-to-one bar gave me my first gig on a Friday.
Clutch.
When one-to-one bar gave me my first Friday, I was like, oh God.
Here we go.
You can't undo, it's very hard to undo a bad first impression. That's a saying my dad always said.
It's very accurate.
Very hard to undo a bad first impression. So I'm like, I gotta pack up at least, like, worst case scenario, 125 people up in this place, right?
It's a lot of friends. But
so
you're from,
like,
Austin.
Yeah,
so.
I'm like, okay, I'm from here, so I got that advantage. So, like, first thing on the list, it was like, call everyone you know and tell them to bring 3 people. My mom ended up bringing like 25 freaking people.
Amen. She calls like all y'all's like second cousins, third aunt removed in other states. We need you tonight.
Yeah, she delivered, man. She always does. She's an obstetrician. That's a pun. Here we go. My mom delivers every time. Wow.
Every time.
Completely unintended pun. There we go.
We welcome puns around here.
Completely unintended.
And those are the most beautiful, actually.
Yeah, I was like, whoa.
Look at me go. So this is what it feels like.
Yep.
When you walk on a stage, I would be so nervous right about now. What do you think? Like when you get to this point right here and you look out, let's say it's like a really boisterous audience, a lot of people, like what goes through your head?
Like, all right, maybe there's a big crowd out there. Maybe it's really nerve wracking, but it's like, but I need to set my mic stand.
Yes.
You know, one thing at a time.
One step at a time.
One thing at a time. And then after that, I'll grab the guitar.
Yeah.
And I'll, you know, make sure I have a pick. Sometimes I don't have a pick, and I'm like, Jackie!
What do you do?
You
call out for help?
And then I start to have a little bit of a meltdown, and then my bass player is like, I got you.
I got your pick, girl.
Usually people are like ordering drinks or, you know, they're just waiting, and they might not notice that I had gotten on stage, and so I'll do like that. I literally do that every time. It's like a habit.
I like it though.
It's so weird.
And it's like you set yourself ready
exactly.
To get centered. I think calm is a superpower.
Yes. Yeah, and then I just say, hey guys, how you doing?
I love the flip of that. Is your family at most shows?
Yeah, in Austin for sure. There's always at least one of them.
How many siblings do you have?
8.
Wow, what is that like?
Well, when I was younger, it was hard.
Yeah.
Because I'm the youngest.
You're the youngest
yeah.
of 9 kids?
6 of them being dudes.
Wow, that, yeah. You know what? That makes you one strong woman, though.
They used to hold me down and tickle me until I passed out.
Until you actually passed out?
Yeah, one time I peed my pants.
That's brutal.
Yeah.
I'm glad you made it. So that E chord that you first yeah. learned, what's that look like?
Yeah, open E, there it is.
It's beautiful.
It's the easiest one, easy E. The weirdest thing is that I can't even play them wrong anymore. I try to show people, like, I'm like, yeah, I used to play it like this, and then I play it, and it's right. I'm like, no, but I used to mess up, and I would do this. And I'm like, I can't even
mess up.
I can't mess
up. I have mastered this level. That's a very good place to be.
No, but, like, there's a lot of stuff that I do mess up because I don't know how to do yet, but the hardest thing for me was bar chords. What you got to do is you have to push down all of the strings with one finger.
Wow.
And then play, then these three fingers form a chord.
Play something?
So it's like, you know? These are the hardest bar chords because you're going like this. So like this weird muscle.
That's the thing. I don't even think my hands move in that direction. Also, look at these nails. These claws, like,
oh yeah, you would not.
I wouldn't make it. What's your favorite song of yours to play?
Fight.
Will you play us a little bit of that right now?
Do you want me to sing it and everything?
Well, just like the beginning of how it starts.
In front of God and everybody?
No pressure, absolutely not. But like, is there a note like how it starts, just the guitar part?
I can show you why it's my favorite song to play. Mm-hmm. It's like. Yeah, I just like the rhythms.
I do too. Seriously, bless you. Thank you for playing that. That's
no
really
problem.
Special. Do you play encores?
Oh, heck yeah. If they ask for it, yeah. But sometimes they don't. Sometimes it's like a 3-hour show. They're like, encore. I'm like, I don't have any more songs.
You're like, I actually played you all the music I know.
I played you all of my songs.
Wait, what's your bow look like at the end of a show? Do you?
My bow?
Well, what do you,
oh,
is there
no,
a thing?
No.
Do you this?
I just say thanks. Then I turn the amp off.
And we're done.
Thank you.
Off.
Get out of here. Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.